that have existed, God still chooses and exercises the prerogative to save just a few. And I got to tell you all this, it makes me even more appreciative. It makes me more appreciative of salvation to know that God could have chosen not to save me. But the fact that God has chosen to save me makes my election that much more awesome. But I think that he could have just said, no, no, I'm not going to save you. But when he saved me, it was beautiful because he didn't have to save
me.
And I got news for you too. God did not have to save you either.
Amen. Amen. Come on, Reverend.
You turn to your neighbor and says, neighbor, God didn't have to save you. As a matter of fact, God could have destroyed you too. But because of his goodness and because of his mercy, oh God, God is the election. See the gospel story unfolding. He chose some specific. But I gotta tell y'all something.
Come on.
There's something more here. So he has Noah and Mrs. Noah. He has Shem and his wife, Japheth and his wife, and he has Ham and his wife. And the Lord says, I want you to take two of every creature. But God classified the creatures in two categories. He says, I want you to take two of every creature of clean animals. If you all look in verse number 2 of chapter 7, you shall take with you of every clean animal by sevens. We're going to see what that means in just a moment. And then I want you to take two of every unclean animal. And you all, this is a picture of the gospel. Because if anybody understands Acts chapter 10, right, there was for a long time, the Jews had considered all who were not Jews as unclean.
Right. Come on, Reverend Yale.
In other words, you all, if you were not Jewish, you were considered unclean. And if you were Jewish, you were considered clean. But the picture of the gospel here, according to Noah's Ark, is this. That when God said, okay, Noah, I want you to take two of every clean animal onto the ark, that was representative, you all, of the Jewish folk.
Come on now.
But here's the bigger one, because in Acts chapter 10, Peter had a quick vision.
Yes, he did.
The Lord had put out a sheet and had all these animals to come out on the sheet. And the word of the Lord says that God commanded Peter to arise, kill, and eat. And Peter says, well, Lord, no, I can't eat those animals because those are unclean animals.
Right.
But the Lord says, what the Lord has made clean, you cannot make unclean. So when you take that picture and put it here, you will see that when the Lord says, I want you to take unclean animals, the Lord is showing us a picture that we Jewish or we non-Jews or we Gentiles were all part of the salvific plan of the Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, I wish y'all just missed it right there. When you see unclean animals that were going up the ark two by two, you have to remember that is a picture of both you and I being allowed to enter the ark for salvation. We're talking about election. Election includes Jews and Gentiles. Election includes male and female. Election includes African American and Caucasian. Election includes Philippines and Chinese. Y'all gonna get it sooner or later. Election includes a little bit of everybody that exists. And we have it here in the gospel story. But not only do we have this election, you all, how is it that God chose Noah? The Lord says to Noah in verse 1 of chapter 7, it says, enter the ark, you and all your household, for you alone I have seen to be righteous. You all, I want to give you this, that Noah was not righteous because he was all of that and a bag of chips.
Come on, Reverend.
Just like those of you who are saved now, you're not saved because you're all of that. But the Bible says that Noah was declared righteous. In other words, if you look over in verse number 8, it says, but Noah found favor in the eyes of the Lord. In other words, it was by grace that God saved Noah. In other words, through grace, God declared Noah not on the basis of who he was, but on the basis of God. God said, Noah, you are righteous before me. And isn't that how God saves us today? He saves us because of his grace. He looks upon each of you and says, I'm going to declare them righteous. Not because of anything that you have done, but because of God's favor and because of God's mercy, God chooses to save each and every one of us.
Amen.
We're talking about election.
Yes, sir.
But you all look at a further picture. I was amazed to think how God chose in verse number 14. It says, Noah, I want you to make for yourself an ark of gopher wood. Now, I don't know if anybody has done any study, but do you all know what else was made of wood in the New Testament? But there was something else in the New Testament that was made of gopher wood. And somebody says that it was the old rugged cross. And what I find amazing is how God chooses to use a man-made item and he uses it to save you and me. Well, who is it that made the cross? Well, it was man that made the cross, but God took the man-made element of the cross and he uses it as the bridge to save a sinner like you and me. And here we have the ark of Noah being made out of gopher wood. But I need to tell y'all that there is a glimpse of glory.
Come on now.
There is a glimpse of glory in Noah's ark. Because I don't know if you all know, but it says that, Noah, I want you to make the ark with rooms. He said, I want y'all to make. If you didn't miss it, say, I didn't miss it. This is what he says. He says, Noah, I want you to make the ark with room. Now, I don't know about you all, but I happen to think of John chapter 14. When Jesus says, I go to prepare a place for you. And another Bible says in there that King James uses the term mansion. But the appropriate term should be a place. Because Jesus says, I go to prepare a place for you. And here he has Noah making all these rooms for all these animals. And it's amazing that the rooms are all within the ark that are sheltered from the eternal destruction that is on the outside. So the invention in which God uses was wood, just like the cross. But there's something else I need you all to see here. I need you all to see this right here. So the Bible says that in verse 21, he says, Noah, I want you to take for yourself some of all the food which is edible. What was it that Noah and all of his people were going to eat when they were in it? And this shows a picture that when God saves us, he gives us everything we need pertaining to life.
Amen.